माननीय सभासद, माननीय सभापति जी,
ऑथर ऑफ अफर्मेशन सेक्रेटरी जनरल
वेस्ट बंगाल श्री मनीष गुप्ता,
আমি মনীষ গুপ্ত রাজ্যসভায় সদস্য নির্বাচিত হইয়া ঈশ্বরের নামে শপথ করিতেছি যে বিধি দ্বারা স্থাপিত ভারতের সংবিধানের প্রতি আমি অকৃত্রিম নিষ্ঠা ও আনুগত্য পোষণ করিব। আমি ভারতের সার্বভৌমত্ব ও অখণ্ডতা রক্ষা করিব এবং যে কর্তব্য ভার আমি গ্রহণ করিতে উদ্যত হইয়াছি তাহা নিষ্ঠাপূর্বক নির্বাহ করিব।
Honorable members, I refer with profound sorrow to the passing away of Shri Pyari Mohan Mahapatra, a former member of this house, on the 19th of March 2017 at the age of 77 years. Born in January 1940 in Angul district of Odisha, Shri Mahapatra was educated at the Ravenshaw College, Cuttack, the Allahabad University and the London School of Economics. Shri Mahapatra started his career as a civil servant and served in various capacities for 35 years. He was actively involved with the voluntary sector for more than four decades and made valuable contributions to the enhancement of public life as well as championed the cause of women, children and tribals. He was the chairman of the Tagore Society for Rural Development, instrumental in implementing integrated village development programs on the Gandhian model. He also served as the director of the National Aluminium Company and Steel Authority of India and as chairman of the Council of Analytical Tribal Studies. Shri Mahapatra represented the state of Odisha in this house for two consecutive terms from July 2004 to July 2010 and again from July 2010 to July 2016. He served as the chairman of the Committee on Government Assurances, Rajya Sabha, from September 2010 to May 2013. In the passing away of Shri Pyari Mohan Mahapatra, the country has lost a noted civil servant, a distinguished parliamentarian, and a dedicated social worker. We deeply mourn the passing away of Shri Pyari Mohan Mahapatra. I request members to rise in their places and observe silence as a mark of respect to the memory of the departed. Secretary General will convey to the members of the bereaved family our sense of profound sorrow and deep sympathy. Papers to be laid on the table, Shri Piyush Goyal.
Sir, I rise to lay on the table of the House papers mentioned against my name at serial number 1 of today's list of business.
Sri Prakash Javadekar.
With permission, sir, on behalf of Minister of State IC for Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Sri Anil Madhav Dave, I rise to lay on the table of the House the papers mentioned against his name at serial number 2 in today's list of business.
Sri Ram Kripal Yadav.
Mahoday, main aaj ki कार्यसूची में क्रम संख्या 3 पर मैं नाम के सामने उल्लेखित दस्तावेज सभा के पटल पर प्रस्तुत करता हूं।
डॉक्टर संजीव कुमार बले।
उपसभापति महोदय, आपकी अनुमति से आज की कार्यसूची के क्रम संख्या 4 में अपने नाम के सामने उल्लेखित कागजात सभा पटल पर रखता हूं।
श्री मनसुख एल मंडाविया।
सर, विथ योर परमिशन आई राइज टू ले ऑन द टेबल ऑफ द हाउस the papers list against my name at serial number 5 in today's revised list of business.
Report of the department related parliamentary standing committee on health and family welfare. Professor Ram Gopal Yadav.
Mahoday, main vibhag sambandhit swasth aur parivar kalyan sambandhi sansadi sthayi samit ke 99वें 100वें और 101वीं रिपोर्ट की एक एक प्रति हिंदी और अंग्रेजी में प्रस्तुत करता हूँ।
थैंक यू। रिपोर्ट ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट रिलेटेड पार्लियामेंट्री स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ऑन एग्रीकल्चर, श्री मेघराज जैन।
महोदय, मैं आपकी अनुमति से मेरे नाम के सूचीबद्ध खाद्य प्रसंस्करण मंत्रालय के डिमांड फॉर ग्रांट से संबंधित कृषि संबंधी विभागीय संबंधी संसदीय समिति की 38वीं रिपोर्ट सभा पटल पर रखता हूँ।
Report of the Department related Parliamentary Standing Committee on Chemicals and Fertilizers, Sri Palvai Govindaradi.
Sir.
Nahiye. Sri Biswajit Dayamedi.
Sir, I beg to lay on the table a copy, it's in English and Hindi, of the 31st and 32nd reports of the Departmental Parliamentary Standing Committee on Chemical and Fertilizer.
Report of the Department related Parliamentary Standing Committee on Coal and Steel, Sri Ram Vichar Netham.
उपसभापति महोदय, मैं आज के आदेश पत्र में मेरे नाम के सामने सूचीबद्ध कोयला और इस्पात संबंधी स्थायी समिति का 29वां प्रतिवेदन हिंदी और अंग्रेजी संस्करण सभा पटल पर रखता हूँ।
रिपोर्ट ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट रिलेटेड पार्लियामेंट्री स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ऑन एक्सटर्नल अफेयर, श्री डीपी त्रिपाठी। Sri Swapan Das Gupta.
Sir, with your permission, I rise to lay on the table of the a copy in English and Hindi of the 15th report of the Department related Parliamentary Standing Committee on External Affairs 2016-17 on demands for grants 2017-18 of the Ministry of External Affairs.
Report of the Department related Parliamentary Standing Committee on Food, Consumer Affairs and Public Distribution, Sri Sadilal Batra. Shadilal Batra. You are sitting there.
Sir, I beg to lay on the table a copy, each in English and Hindi, of the following reports of the department related Parliament Standing Committee on Food, Consumer Affairs and Public Distribution 2016-17, 15th report of the committee on demand for grants 2017-18 of the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, Department of Food and Public Distribution. Second, 16th report of the committee on demand for grant 2017-18 of the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, Department of Consumer Affairs. Thank you.
Thank you. Report of the department later, Parliamentary Standing Committee on Labour, Sri P.L. Punia.
I beg to lay on the table a copy, each in English and Hindi, of the following reports of the Department related Parliamentary Standing Committee on Labour 2016-17. Number 1, 22nd report on action taken by the government on the observations and recommendation of the committee contained in their 16th report, 16th Lok Sabha, on demands for grant 2016-17 of the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Number 2, 23rd report of the Committee on Demands and Grants 2017-18 of the Ministry of Labour and Employment. Number 3, 24th report of the Committee on Demands for Grants 2017-18 of the Ministry of Textiles, and number 4, 25th report of the Committee on Demands for Grants 2017-18 of the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship.
Thank you. Report of the Department related Parliamentary Standing Committee on Rural Development. Sri Naren Lal Pancharya.
महोदय मैं आपकी अनुमति से आज की कार्य सूची में मेरे नाम के समक्ष यथा सूचीबद्ध ग्रामीण विकास संबंधी समिति का 32वां, 33वां, 34वां, 35वां और 36वां प्रतिवेदन हिंदी और अंग्रेजी संस्करण सभा पटल पर रखता हूं।
थैंक यू। नाउ सर आवर सबमिशंस।
हैड मूव्ड द मोशन ऑफ against the Goa governor, a substantive motion under Rule 168. I would like to know and request that when this motion will be taken up, because I have not been informed as yet and it's not been listed in the business for today. As you had mentioned that day, it will be considered and you will discuss it on Monday.
I reply to you. Yes, your notice is received and it is under consideration, and as and when the Honorable Chairman decides on the admissibility.
Sir, this is well taken, I understand. By the same time, sir, the urgency is lost.
We would
request you to kindly look into it, how the democracy has been murdered in Manipur and Goa.
No,
sir, this is something which has to be discussed.
That all you can
the
say.
Role of governor has been totally unjustified,
has gone against
the principles of democracy,
has gone
against the guidelines of the Sarkaria Commission. In a fractured mandate, it has been the practice.
Digvijay ji,
the single largest party.
Digvijay ji, sir,
and the single largest party
for
the right of refusal.
Digvijay ji, I told you. It is. Why do you say as if it is rejected? It is not rejected.
It may not be
it
rejected.
It is under consideration.
I appeal to
and
you.
We will come back to you.
Sir, urgency is lost.
We will come back to you.
Sir, urgency is lost. Kindly take it up. As
we will
as
come back to you.
Yesterday only.
No, no. You will be informed.
That will be taken up on Monday.
You will be informed, and not only that, the House will be informed about your motion, about your notice for moving a substantive motion.
Sir,
you will be informed.
Sir.
Yeah, please.
First of all, the expression "murder of democracy" by them should not go on record.
Okay.
Yeah. I have got the right to make my request.
Yeah, yeah,
chair.
Yeah.
Why not?
I'll go through that.
So the second thing, the in-house problem of the Congress party should not be shifted to the governor. The matter is pending, sir.
Okay. Let us not go to the merit now. We are not going to the merit of the matter.
The word "murder of democracy" is not an unparliamentary language.
I will examine.
And it cannot be expunged.
I will examine.
Honorable Minister has made his point. I am also making my
point. Yes, I said I will examine. Go through.
Don't go by that.
I will go. I will examine and go by the practice.
The treasury benches and the ministers will tell the leaders in the opposition and members here what to speak.
No, no, no.
What has happened?
He didn't say that.
What has happened is
an assault.
I must clarify.
They lost the election and they have stolen the government.
No, see the point.
You right to speak.
A theft has been committed.
But Anand Sharma ji,
on the constitution.
Anand Sharma,
you expect that we will not even point it out. We will not resist.
Anand Sharma ji, as you have a right, the honorable minister has a right.
No, I'm not questioning his right.
Yeah, has a right. You may disagree, but he is saying what he has to say. You may disagree.
If democracy has
discussion is permitted, you can say all this, no problem.
Because when you don't get a mandate and you commit theft of
We don't go to the merit of that now. Sir Yadavji, now 0 hour I have to take.
Sir, ये बात हुई थी कि आज जो है वो रेजोल्यूशन जो उनका है दिग्विजय सिंह का आज आएगा, और मैं मानता हूं कि इस वक्त गुजरने से बात तो वक्त पर ही होती है, मेरी आपसे विनती है कि आज के लिए इंप्रेशन था कि इनका रिजोल्यूशन आज मान लिया
अच्छा अब
लेकिन ये
आप सुनिए
नहीं
यादव जी
ऐसा महसूस
शरद यादव जी
लगता है
वो For if a given Actually, is, if a notice is given,
yes,
there is a procedure that now with regard to a substantive motion, the honourable chairman has to examine its admissibility and he has to permit the admissibility. And once it is permitted, it will come to you. You will know about it. So, I will convey your feeling.
आज चर्चा करने की कोई बात नहीं थी जो शरद जी कह रहे हैं उस वक्त जो है वो माननीय दिग्विजय सिंह जी ने इस मुद्दे को उठाया था हम लोगों ने कहा कि आप उस पर नोटिस दीजिए नोटिस देने के बाद चेयर तय करेगी कि वो किस सब्सटेंटिव मोशन में चर्चा होगी या किसी और नियमों के तहत होगी उस पर हम लोग तय करेंगे तो इसलिए मुझे क्या लगता है कि इस इशू को चेयर पर छोड़ना चाहिए क्योंकि मुझे लगता है कि जनादेश सम्मान शालीनता से होना चाहिए
ऑलरेडी सर या इट इज यस LOP नो बिफोर LOP हाउ कैन यू से दैट बिफोर LOP नो चेयर इज ऑब्लिगेट टू कॉल LOP व्हेन ही इज स्टैंडिंग
ट्रांसलेट्स टू Murder of democracy.
No. That is expense. You know. That is expense. So don't say about that. That is expense. So you cannot comment on that. Arey, what is expense cannot be commented upon. Sit down. About motion.
शरद जी की बात बहुत सही है सर कि वक्त गुजर गया है सुप्रीम कोर्ट का भी वर्डिक्ट आ गया है फ्लोर पे भी टेस्ट हो गया सब जगह हार गए वक्त गुजर गया विषय समाप्त हो गया सर
ओके यस
माननीय डिप्टी चेयरमैन साहब सर थर्सडे को और फ्राइडे को ये विषय यहाँ जीरो आवर में इस पर उठाया था ये मुद्दा हम लोगों ने और विपक्ष ने मुद्दा उठाया था और आपने फ्राइडे को ये बताया था ऑनरेबल मेंबर दिग्विजय सिंह जी को कि आपका जो मोशन है इस मोशन में गवर्नर का कंडक्ट डिस्कस किया नहीं जा सकता और आपने बताया कि उसके लिए सब्सटेंटिव मोशन देना चाहिए और हमने सभी विपक्ष ने कहा था कि हम मंडे को सब्सटेंटिव मोशन देंगे अब इन्होंने सब्सटेंटिव मोशन दिया है और आज वो डिस्कस होना चाहिए अगर अभी तक निर्णय नहीं लिया है मेरा आपसे अनुरोध होगा कि 2 बजे से इस पे चर्चा होनी चाहिए अभी इसके बीच में अभी 11:15 है इसके बीच में डिसाइड हो सकता है और 2 बजे से इस पे चर्चा की जाए ये मेरा अनुरोध
ऑनरेबल LOP यू आर अ सीजन्ड एंड सीनियर मेंबर लॉट ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इन द पार्लियामेंट बोथ इन राज्यसभा एंड लोकसभा यू नो इफ ए मोशन इज गिवन टू द ऑनरेबल चेयरमैन और टू द ऑफिस सेक्रेटरियट फॉर दैट मैटर There is a procedure to be followed up, and that procedure will be followed up, and decision will be communicated to you. So, okay, now let me go. No. See, yeah, it will be done expeditiously as early as possible. Up by today. No.
The whole urgency is.
No, see, now you see. Now it
the
is no no Digvijay ji
and Goa no, acted
no Digvijay ji
no,
no please
no no
the, you are senior member what
because
can I do such a senior member arguing with me
has been denied to give him
no,
an opportunity
no Digvijay
of refusals always is with the
Digvijay ji
this is the
absolutely no Digvijay ji I have already said It is under consideration of the honorable chairman. Now, if you allege that there is delay, there is going to be delay, it is casting aspersion on the chair. I tell you, don't do that.
Sir, I am only requesting the chair to kindly indicate.
Your request is yes. I accepted your request. I will convey it to the honorable chairman. Sit down. Now, Sri K.K. Ragesh.
Thank you, honorable deputy chairman, sir. Sir, through you, sir. I am demanding the central government to intervene to withdraw the decision of the State Bank of India that decided to increase monthly average balance from rupees 500 to 5000. Sir, SBI also decided to impose a penalty for non-maintenance of monthly average balance prescribed. Sir, it is going to hit 31 crore depositors of the State Bank of India. As we all know, SBI is the largest bank of our country, and the decision of the SBI is going to be followed by all other commercial banks in our country. So it is going to affect the whole economic system, the depositors of various banks in a very big way. And it is not going to affect the rich, but it is going to affect the poor people of our country. And the government, they are asking the poor to open accounts, and they are asking them for digital transaction. And yes, I am obeying what you are saying, but unfortunately you are simply penalizing me for obeying your great orders. Sir, in our country, public sector banks are in deep crisis due to the increase in non-performing assets. And sir, who is responsible for that? Is it the poor? Is it the aam aadmi responsible for that? Sir, it is mainly the corporates. It is the corporate lending which is responsible for increasing NPA in various banks. And what is the action that you are taking? You are not taking any stringent action against those defaulters, corporate defaulters. But at the same time, you are waiving, you are writing off the corporate non-performing assets, corporate debts. And now, you are deciding to resolve the problem at the expense of the poor people in our country, poor depositors of our country. And sir, the decision of the SBI is nothing but a loot of the poor people of our country. And sir, it cannot be tolerated. It is not in the interest of our country. It is in the interest of using the people's money for speculative purposes, and it should be rejected. And I am requesting the government to immediately intervene and direct this SBI to withdraw the decision of the SBI. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sri Rakesh. Yes, all our... Yes. All the... Okay. Okay, all the names who associate will be added in the report. Now, Sri Pramod Tiwari. Yes. Yes. Sri Pramod Tiwari.
Pramod Tiwari. मैं एक अत्यंत महत्वपूर्ण विषय पर सरकार का ध्यान आकर्षित करना चाहता हूं। मानवर पिछले दो महीने में जनवरी और फरवरी में अब ये टाइम जो वेस्ट हो गया सर फिर
बोलो बोलो कोई बात नहीं
पिछले दो महीने में जनवरी और फरवरी में सिर्फ एक प्रदेश महाराष्ट्र में 117 लोग किसानों ने आत्महत्या की है। मैं ये जो आंकड़े दे रहा हूं जिले के हिसाब से सर्वे के मुताबिक दे रहा हूं, बीड में 23, नारायणपुर में 22, उस्मानाबाद में 19, औरंगाबाद में 18, जलना में 14, परवानी तथा हिगोली में 8-8 और लातूर में 5 किसानों द्वारा आत्महत्या की गई है। इसमें 46 किसानों को मुआवजा भी दे दिया गया है। 13 आश्रित परिवारों के मुआवजे को अस्वीकार कर दिया गया है। 58 पर विचार हो रहा है। तो ये आंकड़े, चूंकि मुआवजा दिया गया है और विचार हो रहा है, तो गलत भी नहीं ठहराए जा सकते हैं। सबसे बड़ी चिंता का विषय इसमें जो है, जिसके लिए मैंने ये प्रश्न उठाया है कि ये मौतें अकाल से नहीं हुई है, ये मौतें कम बारिश से नहीं हुई है, ये किसी हालत में कम उत्पादन से नहीं हुई है, ये मौतें इसलिए हुई है कि उत्पादन हुआ किसान का और उसको सही मूल्य नहीं मिला है। टमाटर का, इसके अलावा वहां पर जो नोटबंदी का असर था थोक व्यापारियों ने नहीं दिया है और ज्यादा उत्पादन होने के बावजूद भी नहीं मिला है। सबसे बड़ी चिंता की बात यह है कि किसानों के कर्ज माफ को जो वायदा इस सरकार का था अगर कर दिया गया होता तो ये 114 मौतें सिर्फ एक राज्य में नहीं होती। ये सिर्फ एक राज्य की कहानी नहीं है, देश के कई राज्यों में किसान इसलिए सिर्फ आत्महत्या कर रहा है कि इन्होंने कर्ज माफी नहीं की। उत्तर यूपीए की सरकार ने उस समय 74,000 करोड़ कर्ज माफी की थी, किसानों की आत्महत्या रुकी थी, पर यह सरकार नहीं कर रही है। अभी उत्तर प्रदेश के चुनाव में यह दावा था कि जब पहला कैबिनेट बैठक होगी तो सबसे बड़ा काम यही होगा कि किसानों का कर्ज माफ हो, लेकिन कल पहली बैठक भी हो गई, आज मैंने अखबारों में नहीं पढ़ा है, अखबारों में मैंने पढ़ा है कि अभी तक कर्ज माफी नहीं हुई है। अत्यंत महत्वपूर्ण विषय है, अत्यंत महत्वपूर्ण विषय है। मैं सिर्फ यह कहना चाहता हूं कि अगर अकाल सूखा इन मौत का जिम्मेदार नहीं है, इन किसानों की आत्महत्या की जिम्मेदार मेरे सामने बैठी हुई भारत सरकार है जिसकी गलत नीतियों के कारण 117 किसानों ने आत्महत्या की है। इसलिए मैं सीधा आरोप भारत सरकार पर लगाता हूं कि ये कर्ज माफी करें, और अगर कर्ज माफी नहीं करते तो हर मौत के गुनाहगार हमारे सामने सरकार
में बैठे। थैंक यू। डॉक्टर विज्ञास महात्मे।
थैंक यू ऑनरेबल डिप्टी चेयरमैन सर। आई वांट टू ड्रॉ द अटेंशन ऑफ ऑनरेबल हेल्थ मिनिस्टर थ्रू यू सर टू अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इश्यू। On 14th March, 3-4 days back, in Dhule district of Maharashtra, in government hospital, district hospital, one of the doctor working in emergency or casualty office was beaten brutally, physically attacked. और यदि सर आप वो वीडियो क्लिप देखते तो 10-15 relatives जो है वो लातों से डॉक्टर को मार रहे हैं, इस प्रकार का है जिससे बहुत दुख होता है और देख भी नहीं पाते। Doctor may even lose his eyesight, and this has happened not only here but afterwards in Sayan Hospital, and I heard that in Sayan Hospital and Nashik, in Mumbai and in Nashik also. This is on medical health professional, not only on doctor but medical health professionals too. So it's not related to doctors only, because the doctors are not available to work in medical government hospitals, and they are not ready to work in emergency or casualty ward. So it will be difficult for us to get the doctors to serve the society. And in any emergencies, even in private hospitals also, resident doctors do not work in emergency wards. So this will create a big problem. We are not ready, it's not possible to pay all these doctors high salary, but at least we should create an environment so that they should feel like working in the government hospitals and other medical health professionals also. So we have to create an environment, and that can be created by stringent laws should be there, and then non-bailable offense should be against those who beat the doctors, physically assault the doctors. And in national health policy, honorable health minister has done very well, but that will be implemented through medical health professionals, doctors only. So I want that the health minister should understand, and everybody should feel that doctor will not cause any harm to the patient intentionally. So it's my appeal that stringent law should be created, those should be implemented, and non-bailable offense should be there against if the doctor is physically attacked. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Yes, I know Dr. Maitreyan will support it, being a doctor. You immediately raise, okay, all those who associate, yeah, okay. All right, you are also associate, you can associate, no problem. Dr. T. Subbaraman Reddy. Subbaraman Reddy on very important subject.
Very important subject, sir.
Yeah, really.
This is an alarming rise in forest fires in the country.
Yeah, really.
Measures need to be taken by the government immediately in the top priority. Sir, forest fires are increasing in the country with the pace of global warming. Lot of flora and fauna are destroyed and the rare species are burned to ashes. Now with the onset of summer, the frequency of forest fires is increasing in alarming rate. In Karnataka, about 715 square meters of green cover in the Bandipur National Park reported to have been burned down in fire since February 2017. It is home to about 120 tigers. 120 tigers are living in this forest area, they say, and other wild animals. So fire spreads rapidly because of high humidity, wind speed, prevailing drought condition, dried leaves, and intervention of human beings. This is the cause, main reason for actually this fire, sir. So according to the environment and ecology experts, Mr. Siddhappa Shetty, all forest fires in India, including the one in the Karnataka, are man-made. He said contribution to one kind of shrub called Latanta camara, which grows up to 2 meters for fire. So I must say, if this shrub catches fire, it will convert a ground fire into a very dangerous copy fire. About 40 hectares of forest land are affected by fire. So this shrub has badly affected about 40,000 hectares of forest cover. Even these wild animals find it difficult to pass through the shrub. Just 1 minute. So shortage of forest staff is another factor, sir, very important. So now this must be borne in mind by the government. More than half of the watering holes within the park have dried up, while others have been barely kept operational by pumping groundwater. So I urge upon this government of India to order inquiry into the all such forest fires, including this Bandipur National Park forest fire, to go into the causes and to suggest the remedial measures. I also urge the Honorable Minister of Environment and Forest to frame a national policy on managing forest fires and to implement the recommendations of the Parliamentary Committee on Science and Technology, Environment and Forest, which has given its report to Parliament, to save the forest and future generation.
Yeah, yeah. All those who associate will be, names will be added. I think it is an important, so Honorable Minister, see, forest keeping the minimum required forest coverage is very important for the country, especially at this age of climate change and weather change that is all happening. And I tell you, in Kerala also, where forest fire is very rare. This year there was forest fire in Kerala also. I think the government should conduct a study and find out a solution, how there can be a permanent solution. Yeah, 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 yeah. Something has to be done. Yeah.
ठीक है सर, केंद्र सरकार वैसे और राज्य सरकारों से मिलके इस दिशा में बहुत प्रभावी ढंग से कदम उठा रही है, लेकिन ऑनरेबल मेंबर ने जो इशू उठाया उसको मैं कंसीडर करता हूं।
मोर यस 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 बिकॉज़ नोबडी इज इमीडिएटली डायरेक्टली अफेक्टेड बाय इट, पीपल मे नॉट टेक इट सीरियसली, बट इट फॉर द फ्यूचर इट इज गोइंग टू बी अ सीरियस प्रॉब्लम, देयरफॉर वी शुड सॉल्व इट। नाउ श्री प्रताप सिंह बाजवा।
I thank you, sir, for giving me the opportunity to speak on the matter concerning the security of the nation, sir. Since the last couple of years, we have seen a number of terrorist attacks on our country. Every single act from terrorist groups has violated the sense of security within the Indian community and has also instilled a sense of fear among the people. This is especially true for the people living on the border villages of Punjab, sir, especially in the main six districts from Pathankot to Fazilka. There have been two major attacks in my district from where I come, sir, one in Dinanagar and second was on the Pathankot air base. The peculiar aspect about these terrorist attacks is the modus operandi, mode of operation of the terrorists. For example, in Dinanagar attack in 2015, three Pakistan region terrorists had crossed over from the international border and had attacked a local police station. This fits into the pattern of deadly cross border terrorist attacks on Gurdaspur, Pathankot, Jammu axis in the last 15 years. In fact, the National Highway 44, the main road that connects Punjab to Jammu Kashmir, runs a parallel to the international border and has come to be known as the Highway of Terror.
it is relatively easy to infiltrate from this stretch, this Punjab border stretch, as compared to the heavily mined and guarded line of control as well as the international border in the neighboring Jammu and Kashmir due to the zigzagging nature of the border and also the gaps caused by the Ravi River. A dense fog in winters makes borders vulnerable. That's an added challenge. As the border terrain is broken and forested, it provides an ideal cover for terrorists who can sneak in and reach the busy National Highway 44 that snakes into the border. Sir, meri jo basic ye issue maine uthaya hai, mera suggestion hai government of India ko ke along with Jammu and Kashmir, you have to take the border of Pakistan very seriously. My suggestion is, sir, we must create a village volunteer force from zero line to 5 kilometers of the border. We have around 1,000 villages extending from Pathankot district to Fazilka. And they are very small villages, chote gaon hai, population hai 250 se lekar 500. Mera suggestion hai ke 18 saal se lekar 40 saal ke able-bodied naujawan jo, unko border security force ya army training de, aur Punjab ke paas obsolete 303 ki first or second world war ki sari armory bhari hui hai jo kisi istemal mein nahi. Hum ye naujawanon ko train kar sakte hain, inko weapon de sakte hain, honorarium 5000 se 10000 rupaya de sakte hain aur 25000 se lekar 30000 naujawan bache apne second line of defense ka kaam kar sakte hain army aur border security force ke piche.
Okay, time over. Time over, time over. All right. Okay, okay. Dr. Maitreyan. Okay, bite here. Time over, bite here, bite here. Bite here, bite here, bite here. Maitreyan, Dr. Maitreyan. Dr. Maitri.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Maitri.
8 years have elapsed since the planned and systematic genocide of Vilam Tamils in Lanka in 2009, in which more than 1,50,000 Tamils were killed. So far, no reliable investigation regarding this has been undertaken, and not a single guilty has been punished. After years of crusade for justice in the United Nations Human Rights Council, in the year 2015, a resolution was adopted in the UNHRC, sponsored by the USA and Lanka. As per the resolution, independent investigation of war crimes in Lanka with the participation of international judges and lawyers and jurists should be conducted. But within 48 hours, the president of Lanka openly announced that Lanka will not permit any jurists or lawyers from foreign countries. In the intervening period, more Tamil areas have been colonized by the Lankan settlement. Lankan army in large numbers is still occupying Tamil areas. Lakhs of Tamils who have disappeared have not been found till date. More than 90,000 Tamil widows suffering and thousands of Tamils detained in prisons. Sir, thousands of Hindu temples have been razed to ground and Buddha Vihars built in their place. The present 34th session of the UN Human Rights Council is in progress in Geneva. It is really shocking that to the Tamils the world over that USA, UK and other countries have sponsored a resolution in the UNHRC deciding to give 2 more years until 2019 for Lanka to submit its report. What is worst is the newly added provision that only with the consent of the Lankan government any foreign jurists, lawyers and rapporteurs could enter into Lanka on this issue. The resolution is to be voted day after tomorrow, the 22nd March 2017. My beloved leader, Purachitalevi Amma, in her last memorandum submitted to the Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi, on 14-6-2016, urged the Government of India to take necessary measures to bring to book those in Lanka who had perpetrated the genocide on innocent Tamil Eelams ELM Tamils, and that India should take the initiative in this regard in UNHRC. The Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi, is the most powerful leader in the country today. In fact, he is the most powerful world leader. If Sri Narendra Modi cannot render justice to ELM Tamils, nobody else on the earth can do so. I, on behalf of the 10 crore Tamils across the world, echo the voice of Purakshi Thalaivi Amma and urge the government of India to oppose this resolution in UNHRC in the voting to be held on 22nd March 2017. I also urge the government of India to take initiatives to see that international independent investigation is...
leader, Honorable Prime Minister, to take up the issue and oppose the resolution. Now to be moved by the USA and UK, the investigation must be conducted in a fair manner.
Okay.
Everybody must be permitted to participate.
Yes.
All the experts.
Yes.
So,
associate.
Our Prime Minister has been elevated with the leader.
He must
do it immediately.
Sit down.
Under justice to Tamil people.
Sit down. Rangarajan, your associate.
I want to make only one point. Honorable member has raised several issues. I would like proper reply from the government of India.
Okay.
Don't take it as a zero hour, but it is a very important thing he has raised. I request the foreign ministry or prime minister should come to the house and reply to those points.
You can also associate.
Applaud.
Sir, government of India will have to spell out its stand. What is your stand on this issue? The war was over in 2009 and Sri Lankan Tamils are yet to get justice, and government of India will have to play a proactive role.
Okay.
We are the neighboring country and we are responsible for what happening in Sri Lanka. What is the stand of the government?
Okay,
sir?
Thank you.
Government will have to
Sri Majid Mehman. Sri Majid Mehman. Mr. Majid Mehman is there, no? Sorry, so Srimati Rajini Patil.
Sir, हाल ही में महाराष्ट्र के कई हिस्सों में, खासतौर पे मराठवाड़ा के बीड, लातूर और उस्मानाबाद क्षेत्र में बहुत बड़ी ओलावृष्टि और बेमौसमी बारिश हुई है, और उसकी वजह से बहुत बड़ी मानवीय जीवित हानि हुई है और जानवर भी मर गए हैं। सर, इस क्षेत्र में आपको मालूम होगा, मैंने इस मुद्दे को बहुत बार उठाया है, चार साल अकाल से वो मारे गए हैं, अकाल से पीटे हैं, इतना कि पानी पीने का पानी पीने के लिए भी हमारे क्षेत्र में ट्रेन से पानी लाया पिलाना पड़ा वेस्टर्न महाराष्ट्र से। सर, इसके बाद में नोटबंदी की वजह से हमारे किसान मर गए, क्योंकि नोटबंदी की वजह से जो हमारा जो फसल आया था वो फसल बेचने के लिए बैंकों के पास पैसे बैंक कम दे रही थी, तो प्राइवेट वेंडर्स के पास जाना पड़ा उनको, और जो प्राइवेट लोग थे वो सोयाबीन हो कपास हो उसका आधे से भी कम कीमत में उनको वो सामान अपना बेचना पड़ा। और रबी का जो सीजन होता है, रबी का बोने का सीजन होता है, तो उसके लिए बीज लाना हो, खाद लाना हो, खेती के काम करने हो, उसके लिए भी उनके लिए पैसा रहा नहीं। और अब चार दिन पहले जब बारिश बेमौसमी बारिश हुई है और ओलावृष्टि हुई है, उसके कारण से उस क्षेत्र के लोगों का बहुत बड़ा किसानों का नुकसान हुआ है। सर, सभी तरफ से ये पीटा गया हुआ ये किसान आज परेशान है और वो गवर्नमेंट की तरफ देख रहा है। उत्तर प्रदेश के चुनाव में भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने प्रॉमिस किया था कि जब भी हम चुन के आएंगे हम पहला डिसीजन करेंगे कि हम उनको ऋण मुक्त करेंगे किसानों को। सर, सिर्फ उत्तर प्रदेश के ही नहीं, सिर्फ बाकी स्टेटों के नहीं, पूरे महाराष्ट्र सहित सभी देश के किसानों की ऋण मुक्ति जिस तरह यूपीए गवर्नमेंट ने 72,000 करोड़ रुपए का ऋण मुक्ति किया था, उस तरह से उन्होंने करना चाहिए और इस देश के किसानों को राहत देना चाहिए। और जो ये बेमौसमी बारिश होती है उसमें जब मौत हो जाती है जानवरों की हो या मानव की हानि होती है, जीवित हानि होती है, उसके लिए सर उनको बीमा संरक्षण होना चाहिए। और तीसरी बात, जो हमारा धान जो है, जो हमारा धान है जो बेमौसमी फसल के लिए वो उसको बीमा संरक्षण मिलता नहीं है, उसको बीमा का संरक्षण देना भी बहुत बड़ा आवश्यक है। मैं आपके द्वारा, आपके माध्यम से मैं भारत सरकार को रिक्वेस्ट करती हूँ, विनती करती हूँ कि पूरे देश के जो किसान वर्ग है बहुत ही पीड़ित है, आत्महत्या अभी जैसे बोला गया हमारे क्षेत्र में एक साल में 3000 आत्महत्या हो गई महाराष्ट्र में, तो इस तरह से किसानों की परेशानी हो रही है। आप बड़े बड़े धनिया सेठ को आप छोड़ देते हैं, उनको ऋणमुक्ति, वो भाग जाते हैं देश छोड़ के, फिर हमारे जो गरीब किसान है वो अपना खेत छोड़ के कहीं जाने वाला नहीं है, अपना घर छोड़ के अपना गाँव छोड़ के कहीं जाने वाला नहीं है, उनको ऋणमुक्त करने की आवश्यकता है। अगर किसान जिएंगे तो ही भारत देश जिएगा, इतना ध्यान रखना जरूरी है। किसानों की संपूर्ण ऋणमुक्ति करना ये हमारी मांग में हम आपके माध्यम से करना चाहते
हैं। श्री संभाजी छत्रपति।
थैंक यू सर। देयर इज अ निग्लेक्ट ऑफ फोर्ट्स ऑफ छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज एंड द इनकल्जन इन वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज लिस्ट एंड ब्रांडेड इन यूनेस्को। द मिलिट्री माइट एंड वैलर ऑफ छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज आई इंस्क्राइब डीप इनटू द हार्ट एंड माइंड ऑफ ऑल इंडियंस। द कंट्री हैज गिवन हिम द ड्यू ऑनर टू द फैक्ट दैट हिज स्टैच्यू ऑन द हॉर्सबैक स्टैंड्स इंस्टॉल्ड इन द पार्लियामेंट कैंपस। There are 350 forts directly or indirectly associated with Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. The people of Maharashtra are emotionally attached to everything which are associated with Shivaji Maharaj, and therefore all desire that the forts associated with him are preserved and developed as invaluable heritage of the country. But I am pained to raise that the forts of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, including those under the control of the ASI, are in a state of neglect despite their immense historical and cultural importance. Further, these forts are not yet to be developed as tourist attractions of the country. Annual budgetary allocation for each of these forts is far, far from satisfactory, and it seems stepmotherly treatment has been given to them in comparison to other important protected monuments. I, however, congratulate the central government for keeping some of the protected monuments like Taj Mahal, Agra Fort, Kumbholgarh Fort, Ajanta Caves under ASI as per international standards. Leave all the forts of Shivaji Maharaj, Raigarh Fort where he was coronated as the Chhatrapati. Chhatrapati is the sovereign king, is compared to the biggest fort in the world, the Gibraltar, and it is also called as the Gibraltar of the East. But it is most unfortunate that even basic facilities do not exist at this magnificent and massive fort. Needless to say, former President Gyanendra Singh, Prime Minister Indira Ji, Atal Bihari Vajpayee Ji, Narendra Bhai Modi Ji had visited the Raigarh Fort and witnessed its grandeur. May I also point out that ASI has not been judicious in identification of monuments for submitting proposals to UNESCO for inclusion in World Heritage List. Although it is a matter of great pride that 6 forts of Rajasthan have been included in the World Heritage List, but it is painful to say that the forts of Maharashtra have not been included in the World Heritage List. I request the government through you, sir, that immediate steps must be taken to propose forts of Maharashtra in the World Heritage List of UNESCO. Only good news is that the Chief Minister of Maharashtra has sanctioned an outline plan of 300 crores for the Raigarh Fort. The memorial of Shiv Smarak, which will be constructed worth 3,600 crores, will surpass the height of Statue of Liberty in New York. This is applaudable, sir. But I request the government through you, sir, don't forget the forts which have the living history of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj's royal legacy. Through you, sir, I would like to tell, if the forts are not restored, there will be no fort scene of Shivaji Maharaj, and it is a very pitiable situation if you come to Maharashtra. For the last so many years after independence, nothing has been taken for the restoration of Maharashtra forts, of Shivaji Maharaj's forts. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, yes, all the names may be ordered, all those who... Yes, Minister wants to say something.
इशू उठाया भावनात्मक रूप से न केवल महाराष्ट्र के लोगों के लिए बल्कि पूरे देश के लोगों के लिए इम्पोर्टेंट है और मैं ऑनरेबल कंसर्न मिनिस्टर को इसको बताऊंगा।
नो डाउट, दैट्स करेक्ट। यस सर, प्लीज। श्री विवेक गुप्ता।
उपसभापति महोदय, मैं सर्वप्रथम आपका धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ कि आपने आज मौका दिया मुझे इस विषय को उठाने के लिए। सर, ये विषय खाली टैक्सी ड्राइवर्स का विषय नहीं है सर, ये टेक्नोलॉजी का भी विषय है। टेक्नोलॉजी इंसान के लिए बनती, इंसान टेक्नोलॉजी के लिए नहीं बनता है। सर, अभी रिसेंटली मैं कलकत्ता में अपने घर से एयरपोर्ट जा रहा था टैक्सी में, उबर कंपनी है उसमें गाड़ी में, और वो ड्राइवर काफ़ी दुखी था। तो रास्ते में बात करते करते उसने बताया कि उबर ने अपने रेट कम कर दिए हैं और ओला ने भी अपने रेट कम कर दिए, दोनों में बहुत कंपटीशन हुआ। उस चक्कर में उबर ने क्या करना शुरू किया, इनको पहले मोबाइल का पैसा मिलता था वो बंद कर दिया, इनका कमीशन बढ़ा दिया जो उबर इनसे चार्ज करती है, इनके इन पर कई तरह का उबर ने अपने तरीके कमर्शियल डीलिंग जो है बदली। सर उबर ओला है, कमर्शियल कंपनीज हैं, अपना जो चाहे कर सकती हैं, मगर सर क्या हम लोग आंख मीच के देखते रहेंगे? क्या सरकार इस पर कोई नियंत्रण नहीं करना चाहेगी, कोई रेगुलेशन नहीं करना चाहेगी? सर इनके पास, और ये सर मजे की बात, ये जो टैक्सी ड्राइवर्स हैं जो उबर और ओला के अंडर काम करते हैं, इनके पास जाने के लिए कोई दफ्तर नहीं, क्योंकि उबर और ओला का इंडिया में दफ्तर ही नहीं है। और गवर्नमेंट को, गवर्नमेंट में भी, गवर्नमेंट ने किस विभाग के पास जाए शिकायत करने के लिए, गवर्नमेंट भी नहीं आती है सामने के लिए। तो ये जो ड्राइवर्स हैं उबर और ओला के, इनके पास कोई सुनवाई नहीं है, कोई कोर्ट उनको एंटरटेन नहीं कर रहा है, और गवर्नमेंट उनको कोई सपोर्ट नहीं कर रही। सर ये सर प्रॉब्लम आज थोड़ी थोड़ी दिख रही है। अभी आपको शायद याद हो, थोड़े दिन पहले दिल्ली, बैंगलोर और सब जगह में उबर और ओला के ड्राइवर स्ट्राइक्स पे चले गए थे, इस पे टैक्सी की बहुत बड़ी शॉर्टेज हो गई थी। सर हमारे जैसे कई लोग हैं जो आज भी टैक्सी का व्यवहार करते हैं एयरपोर्ट जाने के लिए, स्टेशन आने जाने के लिए। सर इस सिचुएशन पर अगर जल्दी नियंत्रण नहीं पाया गया तो ये बहुत बड़ा सिचुएशन हो जाएगा। क्यों? क्योंकि ये ड्राइवर लोग की गाड़ी इन लोगों ने खरीदी पिछले एक दो साल में उबर के साथ या ओला के साथ 5 साल का एग्रीमेंट करने के बाद। एक एक टैक्सी ड्राइवर का सर 40,000 रुपये का महीने का खर्चा बंधा हुआ है, किस्ती, ईएमआई, पेट्रोल, डीजल और बाकी सब खर्चे मिलाकर। अब जो हालत आ गई सर, अगर वो 20 घंटे भी एक दिन में काम करेगा तो भी वो 40,000 नहीं कमा सकता है। सर उसको उधार ले लेके अपना जीवन यापन करना पड़ रहा है, और बहुत जल्द वो सर उधार जब न चुका पाएगा तो वो सुसाइड करने पहुंच जाएगा। सर उसके बाद हम लोग जगेंगे, उससे अच्छा हम लोग आज जगे और इस पर हम लोग कुछ ना कुछ कार्रवाई करें। सर गवर्नमेंट इन लोगों को और चूसने पे लगी हुई, सिर्फ इन लोगों पर एयरपोर्ट पे पार्किंग चार्ज भी लगा दिया सरकार ने 150 रुपया करके जितनी बार ये लोग एयरपोर्ट जाते हैं। सर इनका कमीशन जो बढ़ाया गया है वो सरकार के नॉलेज में है कि नहीं मुझे नहीं पता, सरकार इस पे क्या करना चाहती मुझे नहीं पता। मैं आपके थ्रू, आपके जरिए मंत्री साहब से रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहता हूँ कि इस पे कोई स्पष्टीकरण दे और इन लोगों के जो भी तकलीफें हैं उसको निजात दे। थैंक यू सर।
ओके, थैंक यू, थैंक यू। श्री बी के हरि प्रसाद, आई एग्री।
ए बिग नंबर ऑफ वर्कर हु आर कीपिंग अवर ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम ऑन is being squeezed and squeezed, and ultimately it will explode. I think government must take note of it, who okay. are running, taking care right. of the transport system.
Government will take note of it.
And
yes.
must respond.
Okay. Government will take note of it. Okay.
सर जो ऑनरेबल मेंबर ने प्राइवेट टैक्सी सर्विसेज के बारे में बताया है, मुझे लगता है कुछ तो जो प्राइवेट टैक्सी सर्विसेज काम कर रही हैं वो अच्छा भी कर रही okay. हैं, लेकिन जो तमाम तरह की टेक्नोलॉजी और टेक्नोलॉजी के बाद उसका जो एक्सपीरियंस yes. होते हैं उसके तमाम तरह के एक्सपीरियंस, और जो बात ऑनरेबल मेंबर ने कही है मैं उस कंसर्न
इश्यू को
बताऊंगा। Year in succession where both Kharif and Rabi crops have failed due to the severe drought, sir. The state has declared 139 talukas out of 176 talukas as a drought affected. A memorandum seeking financial assistance to the tune of 4,702 crores as per the SDRF and NDRF norms was submitted to Government of India on 15-11-16. So the high-level committee has approved the release of 1,782 crores, which is yet to be released. So the northeast monsoon has completely failed in Karnataka. State has recorded only 54 millimeter of rainfall against the 188 millimeter of rain, sir. This is the deficiency of -71%, which is the lowest in the past 45 years. After analyzing the seasonal condition as per the Government of India, India norms, 160 taluk out of 176 taluks have been declared as a drought affected during Rabi 2016. So during Rabi season, an area of 25.98 lakh was sown against the target of 32.25 lakh as an 6.2 lakh hectares was left unsown. The estimated loss due to the agriculture and horticulture crops is 7,097 crores in 13.65 lakh hectares. The agriculture and horticulture crop loss due to the drought for both Kharif and Rabi put together total staggering 25,000 crores, which has disrupted the farmers' lives and severely affected the socio-economic conditions of the state. Sir, the state government has taken some emergency steps to mitigate the effects of this drought. It's been commendable, and it's been swift also, the providing drinking water, fodder availability and employment generation. To mitigate the adverse effect of this drought, state has released 7,763 crores. It is a peanut to supply this emergency water, establishing goshalas and fodder banks and other drought mitigation works, sir. The government of Karnataka has requested the central government to release 3,310 crores from the National Disaster Response Fund to provide some relief to the farmers of these affected areas, sir. The state government is eagerly waiting for the central government to release 1,782 crores, which has been sanctioned by, recommended by the high-level committee for the Kharif 2016, sir. The state is facing a severe drinking water problem in both northern Karnataka and southern Karnataka.
Time over. Sri Vijay Sai Reddy. Vijay Sai, yes. All the, yes. Vijay Sai Reddy. Short.
Sir.
Vijay Sai Reddy, you start, please.
The state of Andhra Pradesh. Sir, the state of Andhra Pradesh.
Only what Vijay Sai Reddy says will go on record.
Sir, the state of Andhra Pradesh is staring at the severe drought for the second consecutive year in the row, sir. Sir, according to the report submitted by the Commissionerate of Agriculture, Government of Andhra Pradesh, the southwest monsoon as well as northeast monsoon both have miserably failed. On account of failure of these monsoons, there is an average deficit rainfall throughout the state at the rate of -28.5%, sir. This is what the percentage that has been given by the Commissionerate of Agriculture, Andhra Pradesh government. Sir, there are 13 districts in Andhra Pradesh state. Out of 13 districts, 10 districts are reeling under severe drought conditions prevailing, sir, therein. Sir, out of 9 districts, there is a deficit rainfall, scanty rainfall, ranging from nine districts. The scanty rainfall is ranging from -20% to -59%, sir. And in particularly in 10th district, Nellore district.
Minus rainfall, okay, all right.
Nellore district, which is considered to be the bowl of rice bowl of Andhra Pradesh, there is a scanty rainfall to the extent of -71%, sir. Sir, there are about 664 of mandals in Andhra Pradesh. Out of 664, 301 mandals are considered to be, have been declared as drought affected mandals in Andhra Pradesh, sir. Sir, in fact, the Kharif crop was targeted to be cultivated in an extent of 27.26 lakh hectares. As against 27.26 lakh hectares, the Kharif was cultivated eventually only 19.5 lakh hectares in the state of Andhra Pradesh, whereas the Rabi crop has shrunk to the extent of 7 lakh hectares in the state of Andhra Pradesh, sir. If you take the overall picture, 30% of the area remain uncultivated in this year, sir. Sir, there's about 5 crore population in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Out of 5 crore population, 2.35 crore population is very badly affected on account of the severe drought conditions prevailing, sir. The drought condition, the drought in Andhra Pradesh has triggered a agrarian crisis which has eventually led to human misery also, sir. In fact, okay. The farmers, sir, one minute, sir. The farmers, sir, from the district of Anantapur, particularly are migrating, farmers and farm workers are also migrating to your own state, Kerala. And if you observe in Kochi railway station, every day, loads of...
Farmers are migrating to Kerala in search of
employment. I urge upon the government
special mention. You can lay on the table, Mr. Anil Desai, you can lay on the table your special mention.
It's only to be later.
Yeah, yeah, there is no time.
Yeah.
Do it quickly.
My special mention was about expeditious clearance of Maharashtra government proposals under National Conservation Plan.
Sri Narayan Lal Pancharia, you can lay it.
Sir, main lay kar raha hu, sir.
Okay. All right, thank you. Sri Majid Bhaman, not present. Sri P. L. Punia, not present. Dr. Maitreyan, not present. Sri Vivek Gupta.
With your permission, I beg to lay on the house my special mention on exploitation of poor Indians in healthcare by pharma companies and private hospitals. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Time over. It is question hour time.